If you are on a special energy tariff that gives you discounted rates at off-peak times of the day, such as Economy 7 or Octopus Go, and you'd like to keep track of that in the Home Assistant Energy Dashboard, then you'll need to do a little bit of automation work to set it up. It's really quite easy to do, so keep watching and I'll walk you through the whole process. You can use the Home Assistant Energy Dashboard to keep track of how much energy your home is using or generating from various different sources. If you configure it to look at your grid import and export sensors, battery energy sensors, and solar generation sensors, then the dashboard will start to graph your usage nice and clearly. If you also configure it with your energy tariff details, then it'll also keep track of how much you are spending or earning. This is my energy dashboard for December. You can see that each day has color-coded segments, and if you hover over each day, it'll give you a breakdown of exactly how much energy each of those segments represent. If I zoom into just one day and then look at these blue bars, you can see that there's two different shades of blue. You've got the dark blue and the light blue. Now the dark blue represents off-peak usage and the light blue is peak usage. And if I scroll down to the sources table down here, you'll be able to see that it's even tracking the total cost of my energy for peak and off-peak there. It's also doing export and gas and everything else. You can add whatever you like into here really. Setting this up is really quite easy, but there are a few steps to follow in a very specific order. I'm going to assume that you've already got some sort of energy sensor paired with Home Assistant, so as you can see how much energy you are using in total. If you don't have that, then you might want to check out something like the Glow display, which I'll put a link to in the description for you. That will get that data straight from your smart meter into Home Assistant. You could also use a CT clamp solution if you like to, but just make sure that you have that solution sorted before you carry on. First, we're going to create two time helpers and we're going to use them to store the start and end times of your off-peak tariff. We'll put them on the dashboard so as you can easily change them if you need to. Secondly, we're going to create a utility meter helper, which will wrap your energy sensor up into a nice, neat, daily cycled sensor. Thirdly, we're going to create an automation that uses the time helpers to switch the utility meter between peak and off-peak tariffs. And lastly, we're going to add it to the energy dashboard so as all of those pretty graphs start being generated. Let's start by creating those helpers then. So we go to Settings, Devices and Services, Helpers, and then Create Helper. We want to choose a date and or time one. I'm going to paste in the first name here. We're going to call it Off-Peak Energy Start. I'm going to give it a nice icon of clock start. And we want to make sure it's just a time entity here. And we click on Create. And we do the same for the Off-Peak Energy End, and I think there's even a clock end icon. Yeah, change it to time only and click on create. Now to make use of these, we're going to add them to our dashboard. So I'm just going to put it on my empty home dashboard here. I'm going to add an entities card. I'm going to get rid of the ones that it's added in by default, and I'm going to put off-peak energy start and off-peak energy end in there. Save it. Done. Now I'm going to pretend this is Octopus Go and we're going to get 4 hours. So let's start this at 12:30 and we want to end it at 4:30 in the morning. Next step is to create that utility meter, and that is in Settings, Devices and Services and Helpers again. We go Create Helper all the way down the bottom and choose Utility Meter. I'm going to give it a name of Energy Grid Import, and we're going to choose an input sensor. Now I've got a simulated Energy Grid Import sensor. Choose a meter reset cycle of daily. Scroll down a little bit. Then in this supported tariff section, you want to type in peak and press enter, and then off peak and press enter. Now it's very important they're typed exactly like this. So see, there's no hyphen between off and peak and it's all lowercase. That's because they're going to be used in an automation in a bit. So making sure they look like this is very important. Scroll down and click on submit to create it and finish as well. Now we need to create an automation that will automatically switch that utility meter between the peak and off-peak tariffs depending on the times that are set in the start and end helpers that we created earlier. We do that by going to Settings, Automations and Scenes, Create Automation, and start with an empty automation. We now need to switch to Edit in YAML mode. Now, in the description for this video, I'm going to put a link to my website and an article covering this whole automation. And in there, you'll see the actual configuration for this automation. So you should be able to just copy and paste it straight in. So I'm going to do that now. Now, take a look carefully. These tariffs here are the ones that you set up on the utility meter previously. So they've got to match exactly, like I said before. And then this entity here is the name of the utility meter that you configured in the last step. Now, if you gave it a different name to the one that I used, you'll need to make sure you've used the correct entity ID here. Click on Save, and you'll see it requests a name there. So I'm going to call it that, and we can go back. You should see it in the list here. Now, obviously, last triggered is never, but at 12:30 tomorrow morning, this should say it was triggered. So you can just keep an eye on that over the next day or two to make sure it's working. And now for the final step, we want to add all these sensors to the energy dashboard. So if we go to Settings, Dashboards, and then click on Energy, what we're going to do is add two items to this grid consumption here. So if we search first for peak, so energy grid import peak, let's say we're going to use a static price of 40 pence per kilowatt hour and save that. Then we do the same for off peak. So I'm going to type in off peak. And let's pretend it's 12 pence per kilowatt hour and click on Save. Once you've added those, you can go and look in the actual energy dashboard itself, and you should see after about a couple of hours, and it will take a couple of hours, there should be some data coming in, and you'll see your graph starting to form, and hopefully even some costs as well down in the sources table. See, I told you it was easy. In a few days' time, you'll have some useful data in there, and hopefully some costs too. Keep in mind that those costs don't include your daily standing charge, it's purely just the variable usage component of your bill. Anyway, I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give this video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.